the legacy of the great Kung Lao.
His legacy was dying in defeat.
He lives on in me, Setsu.
Round one. Fight!
Earthrealm obeys.
Round two. Fight. Finish him! Cetrion wins. Flawless victory.
Hello everyone, and welcome back to another Mortal Kombat 11 Augment Build video. And today, I want to go over my Windy Boulders Augment Build. So this one is really fun, and you'll kind of get what I mean by the name when I go a bit more into the build. But before we get into the video, all I want to do is ask you guys to hit that like button and subscribe, because when you are subscribed and you recommend a video down in the comment section below, I am more likely to do your video sooner, and it really does help me out a lot. And you can always unsubscribe if you don't want to be subscribed anymore, because it's completely free. And it's a win-win scenario, and who doesn't like win-win scenarios, am I right? Oh, and to touch on my one-hit builds, which I previously have on this channel, they're actually not really meant for boss towers. If you want to see boss tower builds, just go ahead and leave a character name down in the comment section below, and I'll make sure to make a boss tower build for them or co-op tower build for them. But sorry if I wasn't clear enough in my videos before. All right, so let's go ahead and hop right into this build video. Alright, so the very first augment I have is a level 3 Bill of Health, so I deal 75% more damage while I'm at full health. This is really good due to the fact that you're literally a tank and you're going to be destroying these guys, the fact that you're even unblockable, right? So having something that increases your damage at full health is really, really good. Because they can't really break free once they're in this kind of combo, which you probably see in the clips of the video of my gameplay. Alright, next is a level 3 special delivery. So my special attacks do 30% more damage. This is really good because both the attacks that we're utilizing for this build are special attacks, so it's a guaranteed 30% extra damage to them. Next is superpowered. So I have 2,000 more health, but my movement speed is reduced by 80% and I can't jump. Due to the fact that we're like a tank, I guess we would be a trebuchet since we're throwing rocks. Alright. But basically this gives you 2,000 health, which basically makes you a tank. And you can take a lot of damage. And talking about taking a lot of damage, next is Crazy Pain. So I deal 40% more damage. However, I do take 60% more damage. But due to the fact that we have so much dang health, 60% damage really, really doesn't matter. But the real focus is 40% more damage. All right, next is Natural 20. So this basically makes all my effects trigger. However, we're not even using effects. We're basically doing this to get rid of our offensive and defensive gauge. You're welcome to all the comments out there who always said I said it wrong. All right, next is running on empty. So basically, this makes your attacks basically unblockable unless your opponent flawless blocks them. But of course, they're not going to flawless block every single attack. And also, it has a little side perk that makes every time you block, it's a flawless block as well. So basically, with these two things, it makes your special attacks unblockable. And since we're basically just spamming our special attacks, this is really good. All right, so the Jinsei augments do actually play a part in this augment build. So the very first Jinsei augment I have equipped is a level 4 defense terrain. So this increases the height of natural barrier by 50%. This is really good just in case somebody spam, like just in case the enemy's trying to zone you or anything, you can easily block the projectiles with your natural barrier. All right, next, this is the one that really makes the build the build. All right, so it's a level 4 rock and roll. So this increases the size of boulders by 50%, which is actually quite a lot. It makes them unblockable because they're really, really big, and you have a lot more room to, well, mess up with your boulders because they can be closer, farther away, and they'll still get hit by the boulders. Next is toss and turn. So deadly wind spins your victims 6 more times. This is really good because you're able to do some type of massive hit damage once they're tossed and turned, and especially when the fact that deadly winds is now unblockable, it really, really helps. All right, so for the abilities, I use H2 port because just in case you're in a corner or something like that, you can't really jump out of it. So H2 port makes you teleport behind your opponent. Really good. Just watch out. It's a bit punishable, but yeah. Next is delayed boulder bash. This is really good because you can kind of get them into this thing unless they wake up or anything that break out of it. You can basically just spam your boulders and indefinitely hit them down to the ground. So they'll have no room to go anywhere. Next is Deadly Winds. So this adds Deadly Winds, which it's like a tornado, and it kind of spits them 6 more durations. So it's really good at comboing. I wouldn't recommend AI behavior just due to the fact that they're not really good at utilizing a move. However, if I would recommend any type of behavior, I would actually have you rush down basically all the way down, maybe turn your combos a bit up, reversal a bit up, and then you're zoning for the rest of it as well. But yeah. So that's build. Let's go ahead into our time and show you how this build does.
You'll let Shinnok corrupt Earthrealm?
I obey my mother's will.
Such a mama's girl.
Round one, fight!
The light purifies.
Round two, fight! Finisher. Cetrion wins. Flawless victory.
Like Shinnok, you betray the Elder Gods.
We serve our mother, Raiden.
You are a triumvirate of evil.
Round one, fight. Round two, fight! Finish him! Cetrion wins. Flawless victory.
You thinking what I'm thinking?
That you are a vapid, arrogant child?
Don't let that stop you.
Round one, fight!
Bless me.
Round two, fight! Finish him.